ever had trouble sending your emails through your WordPress site. We can imagine how frustrating that can be. The most common reason for WordPress not sending emails is your SMTP configuration. Now, setting up SMTP isn't exactly a click and it's over process. One wrong move and you might be causing more email delivery problems. In this video, we'll help you understand what WP Mail SMTP is and how to correctly configure it. All set. Let's dive in. SMTP, or Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, is the industry standard protocol for email delivery. The world's biggest email clients, including Gmail, Yahoo, Apple, and Outlook, use SMTP. It allows you to send and receive emails without being blocked by spam filters. WordPress has a reliable WP Mail SMTP plugin that also has several helpful features, including email alerts to inform you if your website is unable to send emails, native integrations with email platforms like SendinBlue and SendLayer, and email reports that show your tracking and deliverability statistics. To set up WordPress SMTP, you must choose a mailer. For this, you can either use a Gmail account or a business email address from your hosting provider. In this tutorial, we'll go through both methods. If you're thinking about partnering with an email provider, Bluehost offers multiple email solutions such as Professional Email and Google Workspace. You can choose either of them based on your requirement. Both offer the option of a branded email address that matches your domain name. To install the WP Mail SMTP plugin, log into your WordPress account and head to Plugins, then Add New. Type in the plugin name and you'll be directed to the results page. Select WP Mail SMTP and click the Install Now button next to it. WordPress will now download and install the plugin for you. After this, you'll notice the Install Now button will change into the Activate button. Go ahead and click on the Activate button. Upon activation, you'll see the setup wizard. You can skip this part as we'll show you how to set up WP Mail SMTP manually. Head over to the WP Mail SMTP settings page, which you can find in the left-hand side menu of your WordPress dashboard. To use WP Mail SMTP, input your SMTP settings. The initial part of the settings will be similar irrespective of your web hosting provider. Here you could configure the following fields. This is the address your recipients will see as the sender. You can use your website's domain email or any other email address you prefer. This will be the name displayed as the sender. We recommend using your business or website name to build trust. Check this option to receive notifications of successful delivery or bounce messages. Let's start by configuring your emails using the Gmail SMTP server. Scroll down to the Mailers section in your WordPress settings. This is where we'll configure everything. Next, choose Gmail as your option. A new section will appear below, which contains two essential fields, Client ID and Client Secret. To obtain these, open a new tab or window, log into your Google account, and access your Google Cloud Console. You'll need to create a new project on your Google Cloud Console dashboard. Click on the project's drop-down in the blue admin bar at the top of the page. In the pop-up, choose to create a new project. Enter a project name, select an organization, and click Create. Now enable the Gmail API for your project. On the sidebar, locate API and Services, and select Library. You can either search for Gmail API or find it in the category column. Then click Enable. Next, click on Create Credentials. You'll need to answer a few questions to proceed. For which API are you using? Select Gmail API. For what data will you be accessing? Choose User Data and click Next. Google will then request some basic information about your app. Feel free to name your app and select your email address for user support email. The app logo is optional. Enter your email address in the Developer Contact Information field and click Save and Continue. Now in the Application Type dropdown, choose Web Application. You can keep the name field as is or customize it however you like. This name is just for console identification and will not be visible to others. In the Authorize Redirect URI section, return to your WordPress site, copy the URL from the Authorize Redirect URI field and paste it into your Google Cloud Console. Click Create and then Done. Now click on Credentials on the left side. You'll find your web application name in the OAuth 2.0 Client ID section. Select it, and you'll find your Client ID and Client Secret on the right side. Paste the Client ID and Client Secret values into the corresponding fields in your website settings. Then click Save Settings. Next, click the Allow Plugin to Send Emails button. You'll be redirected to the Google login screen to grant permission. Now, let's try sending a test email to ensure everything is working correctly. Under the WP Mail SMTP Settings section, select Tools and click on the Email Test section. Enter a valid email address you have access to. Once done, click on the Send Email button. The WP Mail SMTP plugin will send an email message using the settings we configured earlier. If successfully delivered, you'll see a success message appear on the screen. You can also set up WordPress SMTP using the business email address from your hosting provider. Note that the process may vary depending on your hosting service. Here, we'll be using Bluehost to set up the email address on the hosting panel. Get started by logging into your Bluehost account and clicking on the Advanced option. Clicking on Advanced will lead you to your cPanel dashboard. Under the Email section, click on Email Accounts and then Create. Fill out the form to set up your email account. Now there are two important details you'll need from your hosting provider: SMTP host for your email address and SMTP port for secure login. To obtain this information, select the email account you just created and click on Connect Devices. Scroll down to the Secure SSL/TLS Settings section and take note of the details you see on screen. Once you have the necessary information, you can proceed with setting up WP Mail SMTP for your WordPress website. Head back to the WordPress dashboard and look for the WP Mail SMTP on the left-hand side menu. Click it and you'll land on the WP Mail SMTP settings page. As mentioned, the initial part of the settings will be similar. Under the Mailers section, select Other SMTP. Scroll down the screen to explore additional options for setting up SMTP. Typically, the SMTP host is mailed at yourdomain.com, where you replace yourdomain.com with your own domain name. Remember, this is the address where your emails will be sent from. Next, choose your encryption. You can select either SSL or TLS. Here, we select SSL as our encryption type. As for the SMTP port, 465 is a commonly used option for Bluehost. You can confirm this on the cPanel dashboard. Let's now move on to authentication. Swap over to the Authentication tab, and here's where you'll enter your SMTP username and password. This is the information you copied from the cPanel dashboard earlier. Once you've entered all the necessary information, don't forget to hit that Save Settings button. This ensures all your changes are securely saved, and you won't lose any progress you've made. Fantastic! You've successfully configured your SMTP settings. You can send a test mail to verify if the configuration was successful. While WP Mail SMTP is a reliable solution, you might still face some issues. Don't worry though, we've got you covered. Let's take a look at some common issues and how to solve them. One common problem you might encounter is using the wrong port number. To resolve this, double-check your SMTP settings. Ensure you've entered the correct port number specified by your email provider. Another issue you may face is incorrect credentials. Double-check if you've entered the right username and password for your SMTP authentication. You might want to check if you have caps lock on as well. This simple step can resolve authentication-related problems. Sometimes your email provider's firewall or security settings can cause connection issues. If you suspect this might be the case, don't worry. There's a solution. You can add, delete, or change ports on your firewall configuration settings. If you're unsure how to do this, we recommend you contact your hosting provider for assistance. To identify other issues, even before they cause problems to your emails, use the WP Mail SMTP log feature. This feature keeps track of all your email delivery attempts. By reviewing these logs, you gain valuable insights into the delivery process and pinpoint and resolve any potential problems. And there you have it. You set up a reliable and secure way to send emails from your WordPress site with WP Mail SMTP. Go ahead and enjoy a smoother and highly reliable email experience for both you and your customers. And remember, if you've hosted or are planning to host your emails and website on WordPress, we're happy to help. Head over to our website on the description below and start exploring our hosting and web solutions today. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like and share it with others. Also, subscribe to our channel for more WordPress-related videos.